Why should we suffer two election cycles? The case they're hearing today was brought in 2016. So, we can't wait for those cycles to happen. We need to stop it.
Right. And it's interesting, too, how it's spun, you know, because, I mean, I'm always interested in the marketing side of things and the way that the media portrays things. And if you look at this, there's a quote that I saw. It says, "This is fortifying our democracy." That's what this does. And I'm like, oh, my gosh, like that. You could not say a bigger lie about this thing. Right.
I guess you're fortifying the democracy and all the people outside the fortification is what you're doing.
It's like a huge power grab from the state.
Yeah, that's right.
More control of in the hands of the federal government. And it's like it could be. You cannot be farther from the truth when you say it's fortifying our democracy, but yet people will buy into that, right? I mean, the Pelosi's of the world and the Democrats of the world are like, this is fortifying our democracy, and it's actually good for campaign finance, and it's good for the little person, and this is what they're saying. This is how they're spinning. It's just a big bunch of crap, you know?
Honest to goodness, it really is. I mean, AMAC spends all of its time studying. I mean, they oppose bad bills and they support good bills, hundreds of them. And they listen and they try to speak for the constitutional rights in particular that matter to people. This is a travesty. This is really a bill that is a sheep, you know, a wolf in sheep's clothing.
Right.
It's being put out there, as you say, as if it's some sort of protector of democracy. But what it's really doing is it's consolidating one party rule. That's what it's trying to do.
Yeah.
So, you know, we just average Americans need to recognize, first of all, their voice matters. Secondly, I know we're tired, but it's time to remember that you can speak at your state legislature. You can speak in town meetings, in school board meetings. You can speak up all over the place. And AMAC, you know, folks that are over the age of 50, and again, fastest growing organization in the country for conservatives, over the age of 50, they've lived through a few things, and they understand, you know, Ronald Reagan's perspective on the world. And I think that we just have to keep reminding ourselves, because as Reagan once said, it doesn't get passed down through the DNA. You got to fight for it.